Those of us who reside in Brooklyn Heights understandably take for granted the open space provided by beautifully landscaped Cadman Plaza and Park. Access to a farmer's market, large artificial turf for field sports, outdoor surface track, and just a beautiful place to sit and relax on a bench or lay a blanket out for lunch. On any given day, the park is filled with parents and children or individuals just taking their dog out for a stroll. Couple this with the much-anticipated Brooklyn Bridge Park, and we in Brooklyn Heights have a lot to be thankful for. It wasn't always that way. Much of the downtown Brooklyn area was shrouded by elevated rail systems that blocked sunlight and were noisy and dirty. This short film will show you what was there before there was a Cadman Plaza and the stages of evolution of a park that is so dear to us today. Montague Street was a major thoroughfare for traffic to and from Wall Street via cable cars to the Fulton Street L and the ferry shuttling back and forth to the island in Manhattan. Some of you may be wondering if I have a preoccupation with transportation, but any discussion concerning the transformation of downtown Brooklyn has to begin with L's and their dismantling. As you will see later in the film, the completion of Cadman Plaza Park would have been impossible if not for the eradication of the Sands L terminal. Downtown Brooklyn was a main hub for elevated tracks, with both the Sands Terminal and Fulton Street Station serving as crucial intersections. looking at these pictures, it is obvious that any park with an L serving as its backdrop isn't a park at all. At least not if you want peace and tranquility. In the next film, we'll show what happened in the surrounding area, like the building of the Cadman Tower Apartments and Brooklyn Gas Building on the corner of Montague, and the destruction of the Brooklyn Eagle Building for the State Supreme Court Building. I'd like to take this time to give a special thanks to the Brooklyn Public Library and the Brooklyn Historical Society. Without their resources, this wouldn't be possible.